Hello people, in this video I will explain what is Anaconda, Jupyter Notebook and Spyder in Python. I will first explain what is Anaconda and how it differs from regular Python. Then what is Jupyter Notebook and why it is used. And finally what is Spyder. If you are already familiar with any of this topic, you can skip that certain portion from description. So this video is Python specific. If you already tried Python, then you may know how you can go to official site of Python and download executable exe, or if you are on Mac or Linux, there will be something else to install Python on your system. However, Mac and Linux already comes with Python installed. But it's always good to check which version you are using, because system may have installed Python 2.x instead of latest one, which is 3.x. It's always better to use Python 3 instead of Python 2. So the point is, there's not just one way to use Python on your system. And for this, Anaconda comes in. Anaconda is free and open source distribution of Python. Anaconda is not just Python distribution, it is our distribution also. It's mainly focused on providing everything for data science and machine learning applications. It have more than 150 packages included along with Python core language. Anaconda is also environment manager. Word conda is also related to Anaconda distribution. And how? Anaconda have its own package manager, which is conda. Conda is package management system just like pip in regular Python. You can install packages in regular Python using pip install command, whereas in Anaconda you will use conda install. Let's say I want to install YouTube DL, then I will use pip install YouTube DL in regular Python. But in Anaconda, I will use conda install YouTube DL. There's also another command, conda build, to create your own custom packages for sharing. And also, you can upload them to Anaconda Cloud. You can download other people's packages and install them without login. When you install Anaconda, you will also get GUI, which is called as Anaconda Navigator. With Anaconda Navigator, you can install and update packages in environment, and it can also search for packages in local Anaconda and Anaconda Cloud. So this is it for Anaconda, and summary is, it doesn't just regular Python. Mainly, it is targeted to them who are not full-time developers. Anaconda provides cloud and also GUI if you want to launch applications from Anaconda Navigator. So if you are happy with regular Python, just like me, then it is totally fine. Next two topics, which are Jupyter Notebook and Spyder, are also comes with Anaconda, and what's that? Let's look at them. What is Jupyter Notebook? In simplest word possible, you can say that it is web-based interface. So the Jupyter Notebook is an open source web application which contains live code, visualization, etc. The power of Jupyter Notebook is, it gives you live code and visualization at one place. To better understand, let's look at this picture. Here you can see that it's easy to understand code in Jupyter Notebook than IDE like PyCharm. Because Jupyter Notebook gives you power of live code and visualization, it becomes more easier when you share your code to others. Regarding to Jupyter Notebook, I should say when you share your notebook. Yes, notebook. This all which contains live code and visualization is notebook. In older days, it was IPython notebook. And with that said, it is just not limited to Python. Jupyter Notebook supports more than 40 programming languages, including R language and Scala. So now its new name is Jupyter Notebook, and it's a notebook which you can say document can be shared using Gmail, Dropbox, GitHub, etc. Some developers may prefer to run their first code in Jupyter Notebook instead of regular Python interpreter, because Jupyter Notebook provides great visualization like tables and graph and even videos with live code. In regular Python, you have to comment your code so that other developers can understand your code, but with Jupyter Notebook, you can easily explain everything using live code and visualization without commenting. Isn't that great? So, if you are teaching someone, then this provides best way to explain your hard work. This is all I have for Jupyter Notebook. So let's move on to the next one, Spyder. Spyder is open source cross-platform IDE, which stands for Integrated Development Environment. And if you don't even know what is IDE, IDE provides comprehensive facilities to develop your application. Spyder IDE is numerical computing environment, and credit for this goes to IPython and Python libraries like SciPy and NumPy. Spyder IDE provides tool for data inspection. It highlights syntax, provides Python console and many other things. And if you are a developer, you already know how IDE works, so I don't have to explain it further. I hope this video will be helpful. To get more content, you can support me by subscribing to this channel or you can follow me on social media. Bye-bye and see you in the next video.